A healthy network connection is important for supporting alarm communications and other AlarmNet services. For cell communicators, a healthy network consists of a strong signal with minimal noise. Placement of the cell communicator or antenna can have a huge impact on the quality of the cell connection. Hi, I'm Mike with Resideo, and in this video, I will review some factors you should consider when selecting a mounting location for a cell communicator. To start, you should familiarize yourself with the specifications and guidance found in the communicator installation instructions. There, you will find information on wiring limitations and other factors that will help you properly install the device and optimize the installation for best performance. A thoughtful installation commonly includes a survey of the site to find a mounting location that will be favorable for cell communication and minimizes the potential challenges that can cause degradation to the signal quality in the future. Some locations can be considered potentially problematic and should be avoided. As an example, here we have a Vista security panel that's mounted in a commercial warehouse environment. Now, it'd be very tempting for me to mount the communicator on top of the Vista can, and I may get acceptable signal. However, I do have some immediate concerns about this environment. Not only do we have these electric distribution boxes that can emit some electric noise, some EMF, but we also have a lot of metal in this environment, just several factors that give me concern for future degradation of the cell signal. I will rule out this location and opt for a remote mounting location instead. Remember, you will want to avoid installing the communicator too low to the ground, in areas like a basement, areas that aren't climate controlled, such as an attic, on metal or in a metal enclosure, close to sources of high voltage, or any enclosed areas with lots of potential interference. For best results, it is recommended to install the cell communicator vertically, as high as possible, and close to an exterior wall or a window. It's also recommended to install the communicator on a surface such as wood or drywall, and to make sure that it is installed away from any potential source of interference. Now, as an alternative to remote mounting the communicator itself, I may opt to use a remote mounted antenna, such as this cell-ANT3DB. When searching for a suitable mounting location, we suggest using the communicator itself or a similar model to test for signal. Due to the differences in cell technology, you should not use your cell phone for this testing. It is best to use the device itself or another test device that uses that same network technology. This means if you're installing AT&T, test with an AT&T device. If you're installing the LTE Cat M1 device, then be sure to test with an LTE Cat M1 device. When moving the communicator around to test for signal, you can power the device off of battery power. Once you find a suitable mounting location, it is best to power up the device and test for signal before drilling holes and running wires. I have fabricated a power cable and will use a small 12-volt battery to assist with this testing. This will allow me to move around the installation site and identify the best mounting location. When testing the quality of the signal connection, you will want to observe the onboard signal LED. On this model, the LTE MXA, when testing for acceptable signal, you will want to see the signal LED on solid. If it is flashing or if it is off, the device is not getting good signal and should not be placed there. Refer to the installation instructions for more info on the signal LED with the device you are installing. I've been testing various locations at this installation site, and I find great signal in this upstairs storage closet. This is a drywall mounting surface and is free from any potential sources of interference. This also happens to be an exterior wall, so it meets all of the recommendations found in the installation manual. Now that we have found a suitable mounting location for the device, I will complete the registration and I will be sure to test the signal level and signal quality via AlarmNet 360 before I leave the job site. For additional information, please visit Resideo Academy. Thanks for watching.